这里吗？
那我先来简单介绍一下我的工作经验。我从事外汇交易到现在已经有20多年的时间。从1993年开始，那我第一家服务的公司呢叫做FXMATE Brother。
Foreign Exchange Broker, Voice Broker.
OK, 我第一次刚开始作为外汇交易经纪商的一个工作人员，那家经纪商现在虽然已经不在了，但是他当时在市场是非常享有盛名的。
Yep, and in 1995, I went over to ANZ Bank, Australia and New Zealand Bank, as a junior trader, dealer, in the foreign exchange market.
1995年呢，我加入了澳大利亚新西兰银行，简称澳新银行，作为一个初级的电话交易员。
And so, by the year 2000, I was made the head of margin foreign exchange for the ANZ Bank Group.
那到2000年的时候，也就是我28岁的时候，我成为了澳新银行在新加坡的外汇交易的主管。
Now I'm a little bit older and uglier. I do have some little bit of experience in the foreign exchange market, especially how a bank trader make money for the banks. And I'm sure, thank you for your coming here, and I'm sure this is what you'd like to learn, how bank traders make money for the banks, right?
那虽然我看起来还没有那么年轻，但是我现在的经验是相当的丰富。今天呢，我们为大家带来的话题是，银行的外汇交易员是如何为银行赚钱的。那因为我在银行工作了很多年的时间，那对于我来说，我是有资格去谈论这一话题。那非常感谢大家前来，与我们进行交流。
Don't forget the ugly part, right? Look, how many people, may I show of hands, who knows anyone who's been a trader in a bank before, in a treasury department?
那大家现场大家有没有认识在银行做交易的交易员？请举手让大家看一下。
Any friends or relatives who's traded in a bank?
有朋友和家人在银行工作吗？有，我看到有两位。
Okay, so very stressful job.
有觉得压力很大吗？工作？Yes.
I love it. I love it.
对我来说，我是非常享受这份工作的啊。
Right, so let's begin, shall we? Have you got the the?
Wait a second.
How do I turn the? Okay, you do.
Okay.Okay.
You don't want to see that. That's all right.First, we have to show this because that's part of our regulations in Australia. We have to follow the laws and regulations under the Australian Financial Services License very strictly. So that's our disclaimer.
这是我们的免责声明。那大家都知道澳大利亚的法律是非常严格的。那我们受澳大利亚的法律监管，我们必须要在每次做演讲之前把这个放给大家看一下。
Oh, in Chinese, I hope. Okay. So, we'll go to the first question. What is the main role of a foreign exchange trader in a bank? Well, the foremost, we'll put point one up. We are a market maker in a bank, right? So, what that means is that anybody...who has a relationship with a bank, for example, another bank, or the bank's clients, like Apple, for example, or BMW as a company, they require foreign exchange. So they would require a bank to perhaps look after their foreign exchange requirements. And also, other banks could also ring each other for prices, foreign exchange prices.So as a trader, we are obliged to make a two-way price. We are a price maker. So we have to make a price for two ways. In other words, a bid and an offer.
那我们第一个来讨论的话题就是呢，一名外汇交易员在银行当中扮演的主要角色是什么？那第一个功能毫无疑问就是做市商的角色。 那做市商呢，顾名思义其实就是需要我们去报价，那个报价呢包括两个方面，一个是买入价，另外一个就是卖出价。这个过程可能发生在银行和企业机构，企业机构或者是其他银行之间。那比如说，苹果和宝马这样的大公司，他们也许需要将他们在主营业务地区之外的地区赚来的钱换成他们的主要使用货币，这时候他就需要银行去为他报一个价格来兑换他们需要的货币。
So when a bank calls us.Or the customer calls us, we have to make, for example, dollar yen price. So if they call us and they say, no, we don't have music, we just quote prices. Where's the music?
It's another
side. Oh, okay. I have to talk louder now because I've got to fight over this music. So when we have to quote a price, we have to quote a two-way price. So for example,If dollar yen, the market.
Thanks.
So if US dollar yen.If the market price was at 108.62, this being the bid, this being the offer, this is where I will buy, this is where I will sell to the counterparty, to the customer or another bank.
那这里我们举个例子，我们是怎么报价的呢？那就以美元对日元为例。那大家可以在这里看到是108.6，108.62。那左边的价格呢，就是我们的买入价，而右边的价格就是我们的卖出价。
So I have to make this very, very quickly. So if a ring calls and says, "Hi, hi, Corey, dollar yen in 5 million," for example.
那这一过程往往是非常迅速的。那可能我接到一个电话，哎，说 "Hi, Corey, 你能不能帮我买入500万美金，然后兑澳元？"
So instantaneously, in about 1 or 2 seconds, I have to say, dollar yen 61.62.
那这个过程是这个报价的过程会是非常迅速。那我就会立即答复他，60.62.
Why? Because I want him to sell it to me. I don't mind being long. I think the market's going to go up. So therefore, I quote him a better bid price.Hoping that he is also, right, a seller, right? So he would not deal with this because he can hit the market with that. But he would hit this because this is better. And I don't mind it because I want him to hit me at 61. Because I want to buy at 61, right? I don't want to sell it to him at 62. If I was a seller, I would quote him 60.61. If I want to be a seller, but I don't want to be a seller, I want to be a buyer. That's why I quote him 61.62. Is that okay? Everyone understand?
这里我给大家解释一下。那是这样，假如我认为市场将会在后面的一段时间向上走，也就是市场会上涨，那这个时候即使市场价格是60.61，那我报给他的价格会是60.62，因为我不想让他去以这个价格成交，那我故意会把这个价格报得高一点，这样成交就不会完成。那这样的话，我就可以尽量多的买入这个相应的货币对。那同样的道理，如果市场将会下跌的话。我就会把价格报到61.62，这样的话买入价就不会那么容易去成交，因为它比市场价格高。那我就会以更低的以尽量去卖掉更多的相应的货币对。
Okay.
大家明白吗？清楚吗？
I'll go a little bit slower. Sorry, I'll go a little bit slower.
Okay.
I'll go a little bit slower.
All right.
I'll say that I'll go a little bit slower because they don't understand.
All right, okay. 那我们接下来速度可能会放得慢一点，以便大家理解。
Basically, my job is to actually give the price to the customer very, very quickly. And I can give any price I like as long as it's competitive. As long as it's better than the market. That's why they call me. I want a good relationship. So that's why I need to quote something that's better than the market. I can quote this number.So the idea is to quote them a better market than the market.
Okay, 那是这样，我们这样来理解。那我的工作呢，肯定是为企银行招来更多的客户，那让客户进行交易更顺畅，给他们更好的价格。那当市场是这个价格的时候，我愿意以高于市场的买入价把这个价格报给他。这样的话，我们能之间能维护更好的关系，客户也会更满意。
Okay, so at the end of the day, when I quote a price, they're going to do business with me. They're going to say yours at 61, they're going to sell it to me at 61, or they're going to say mine, I'm going to buy it at 62. Right, so they have a choice. They can sell it at 61 or they can buy it at 62. Now, when they buy or sell, I've got a position.When I quote the price,
yes.
Right, they deal, either way they deal at 61 or 62, it doesn't matter. I have a position.
Okay. 那这里我报的价格呢，我并不是想要让大家去偏向于哪一方，买方或者是卖方，这是我的报价，既有买入价也有卖出价，我不会因此而考虑我的仓位是怎么样。无论从哪个方面来走，我都是受益的。
Alright, so everyone understand that if I get hit by a price, I have a position. Yeah, does everyone understand that?
那大家是否都明白？如果我报出这样的价格，如果有人接受这样的价格，那我就持有了相应的仓位。大家理解这一点吗 ？Okay.
Okay. Alright, so I have a position. So I have a risk.
那这时候当我拥有仓位的时候同样我也就拥有了风险
Just like if you have a trading platform and you buy or you sell that means you have a position you have a risk an open position yes
大家是否理解当你开了一个仓位之后你也就相应暴露于相应的风险之下因为市场是在变化当中的
Right.So, how do you manage that risk? How do we as bank traders manage that risk? That is another very important role of being a trader.
那对于一个交易员来说，如何管理他自己的风险，这是我们要必须要考虑的一件事情，非常重要。
Because the bank employ traders to manage risks first, and then hopefully to make money after.
那银行雇佣外汇交易员的作用在于第一一定是先管理风险其次才是为银行赚钱
Does that everyone agree with that philosophy?
大家是否同意这一观点呢
Yeah, that's nice, that's nice. We're on the same page. Right. So, we'll have the next slide. So, another job of a trader is to provide liquidity into the market.Now, this is not very important for you, but that's another part of a trader's role. You know, when people ring, people call, I have to give prices, I have to deal. Therefore, there's money into the market. I sell, I buy, there's money in the market. That's called liquidity.
那第三个作用呢，就在于为市场提供流动性。这一点对于在座的大家可能没有那么重要，但是对于市场是非常重要的，因为成交量关乎很多东西。
Right, so that's part of the job. I'll do this.
What do I press? Last one.
So at the end of the day, like I said, you know, my number one job is to manage risk.At the end of the day, my number one job is to manage risk.
Okay, 所以那我每天工作的第一要务呢，就是要确保我的风险是在被管理的范围之下的。
And then hopefully I will need to make, I have to make money as well.
那第二件事情我要考虑的才是要考虑去帮银行赚钱。
Okay, so this is where the fun part begins. I have to make money and I have to manage my risk.
好，那也就是我们提到就是说在管控风险的前提之下，然后尽可能多的为银行来赚钱。
So the most important thing that, you know, to keep my job is to make sure that I don't lose more than what my assigned limit is. Every trader has a limit.
我为了不丢失工作呢，我必须要保证我每天的损失不会超过我的限额。每一名外汇交易员都会有他的限额。
So how do traders manage their risks?
那第二个问题我们希望来讨论说，交易员如何能控制他的风险呢？
Well, the main concern, of course, for us is market risk. Market risk is about prices moving up and down, right?
那我们交易员关注的更多是市场的风险。大家可能会知道风险会有很多，但是这里我们只强调这一点。之后我们可能会说一些关于对手风险的事情。市场风险也就是价格会上涨也会下跌，是市场波动性。
So, getting back to why we are here, how do I make money for the bank? Too fast. So, why we are here to show you how I make money for the bank. This is where it starts.
Okay. 那这就是我们今天要讲的重点，说我们到底是如何为银行来赚钱的，作为外汇交易员。
I use the bank's customers or other banks' orders. Orders are how traders use to help make money for the bank. It's a very powerful and very important factor in trying to make money for the bank. It's very important to have clients and to have orders.
那其中最重要的一个办法呢，就是利用客户的交易订单，或者是其他客户的交易订单来为自己赚钱，或者是来管控自己的风险。
So for example, say I have Apple, world famous company, as my bank customer. And Apple says, I need to buy $5 million, right, at 108.20. Okay? And that's an order that the Apple Treasury Department has given my bank to look for them. The market is at 108.60, 60, 62.
那以下我们来假设一个情形，假如苹果是我的银行客户，那这个时候他向我下了一个交易订单，就是说，在市场仍然在108.6到卖出价108.62的时候，他给我一个订单，我希望在108.2的时候买入$5,000,000。
Okay, so as a trader, that's my job. I've got to look after that.
那我是交易员，我就要履行我的职责来帮他完成这一订单。
So if the market goes down, it goes down to 108.25.
如果这时候市场价格从108.6跌到了108.25,
nothing done, it hasn't reached there, nothing done.
因为没有达到我们的交易限额，所以这个时候成交并不会执行。
It goes back up to 108.50.
也许它又会反弹到108.5的位置。
Goes back to 108.30.
然后再次下跌到108.3.
Now, you've seen this sort of thing before, right? You've seen how, you know, how the market can move like that, right?
对，这应该是大家非常常见的场景，价格在一个区间内不断的波动。
Let's make it interesting. You could have that order. You could have this order in the system.
这时候大家假设是 你要去完成的这一订单。
Right. So, if it goes there, back up, and then back down again, well, as a bank trader, because I'm a market maker, right, I could go out and also ask for prices. When it goes down to about maybe 108.27, if I'm lucky, it goes back down to 107, I buy. I call another bank, for example, Bank of China. I say, hello, Bank of China, what's my dollar yen price? 5 million. He will quote me, I don't know, 26, 27, or 27, 28. He's got to quote me two-way price.
Okay. 那现在呢，市场就会在接下来时间内不断波动。如果我们十分幸运的话，它可能会下跌到108.27的位置。那这个时候呢，作为银行交易员，他可能就会打电话给比如说中国银行，他会说中国银行，我现在需要买入$500,000在这个位置，那你给我的报价是什么？这个时候他们可能会给出的报价就是26或27或者28。
Now if the other side trader thinks I'm a buyer, he will quote me this one. If he thinks I'm a buyer, he will quote me 27, 28.
那如果他认为我会买入的话，他肯定会以这样一种方式来给我报价，因为这个的卖出价会高于上面这一个，他们需要赚更多的钱。
Yeah, understand that? Okay. They understand that?
大家理解吗？到现在？
Thank you. Yep. So, but if he thinks I'm a seller, then he might quote me 26, 27. If he thinks I'm a seller.
如果呢，我是卖出方，他一定会以上面这个方式来报价，因为这个的对于中国银行来说，他们的买入价又比卖出价低，他们的买入成本更低。
It's fair, right? I can't. He doesn't have to quote me.The market price, he can quote me anything he wants because he's now a market maker.
那这是一种非常公平的场景，他会按照我们的需求来给我们相应的报价，这就是报价商的作用。
So, he quote me 27, 28, I buy at 28.
那当给我27、28这个报价的时候，我会选择买入在28108.28的价格买入。
So why do I want to buy at 28?
那为什么我要选择在这个价中买入呢？有人可以回答吗？
Is it because I think this is the bottom?
那是因为我认为它在这个位置附近受到了强有力的支撑，所以这可能是在一个短阶段性的底部。
But where's my risk? My risk.Is only 8 pips.
That 大家可以看，在我买入的这个时候，我的风险有多少？那答案就是只有八个点。
Because I have an order at 20.
因为我还有苹果公司交给我的订单在108.2.
If I'm wrong.And the market goes down.
That 如果这个时候我的预判错了，市场接着下跌，跌到了108.15的位置。
Well, I'm protected.
这个时候我是受保护的，因为仍然有苹果公司的订单在我的上面，在108.2。
Does that make sense?
大家是否能理解？
But if I'm right, that could go up to 50.
那
如果
我的预判对了，价格在这个位置确实受到了支撑，向上走了，我会赚钱。但是如果向下走了，我也是受到保护的，因为苹果公司的订单在我的之上，我会在108.2的时候顺利离场。
Does that make sense? So my risk is small, but my reward is based on the market movement and my analysis, the profit is higher.
这就是现在的情形，说我们承担的风险实际上是特别的小，只有八个点，但是如果我们的预判是正确的，我们的回报会是非常的多。
So that's one way of how traders make money for the bank as well as their customer, because it's fair. You know, if it goes down to there, well, this order's done. If it goes to even 108.20, the order's still done. I have to do the customer. Otherwise, Apple will say, you are no good.I gave you an order, the market is 20, you didn't do me, I don't want to do business with you anymore.
那这情形是非常公平的，我们在之中受利，同样苹果公司它的订单也得到了交易，我们必须要在确保苹果的订单苹果的交易订单执行之后，我们才能做之后的事情，因为这是我们的工作。如果我们无法在108.2完成交易，而市场已经到达了那个位置，那苹果以后不再也不会跟我们做生意了。
Does that make sense? So as a trader, you know, I got to look after the customer as well as manage my risk as well as try to make money for the bank.
那这个时候呢，我在完成客户指令的情况之下，还为银行赚到了钱。
And so I can do all that in a very fair way.
那我完成这一过程呢，是用一种非常公平的方式完成的，并没有利用自己的职务便利而去使苹果或者是任何一方受到损失。
So that's one way of making money. There's many other ways. There's also a way called the stop loss way, but because of time, I can't go into it. But that's one way. I've got to go to the next screen. That's why.
那这就是一种非常典型的方式。因为时间关系，我们不可能一一讲到。但是这是一种非常重要的方式。
Yeah. I'm happy to talk about other ways later at our booth. If you want to come and talk to me, that's fine.
我们会在自己的展位等待大家，如果大家想了解更多的话，我们可以进行接下来的交流。
another one. I'm not good with technology. Oh, I haven't finished.
Alright, 我们还没有结束，大家稍等一下。
Right, soThe third point was trade ahead based on their view. That's what I just showed you, right?
第三点呢，也就是预知风险，提前交易。这就是我刚才为大家展示的我的做法。
Yes. Okay.
大家是否理解？
对。So is there such a thing as a trade risk-free trade? In other words, no risk for a trader.
第三个问题，我们希望跟大家探讨说，对于银行交易员来说，是否存在无风险交易？也就是说，你进行的每一笔交易都是没有承担任何风险的。
And the answer is yes.
我给出的答案是理论上是有的。
Potentially yes. How? How? How can there be any risk-free trade?
那么如何实现呢？是我希望留给大家思考的问题。
Well, when?I get a call from two different clients or banks at the same time.
那一种情形呢，就是说，我作为银行，我可能会接到，Corey, despaired. 那我可能会接到来自两个方向的订单，一个是买入，一个是卖出，关于同一个货币对。
So for example, say.Bank of China. So Bank of China calls me and it's Bank of China, HSBC.
Yeah.
Okay.
ICBC.
ICBC?
No,
no. 108. I put in 108, say the market's at 60, so I've got a 108, 60, 62. 108, 60, 62. And say that's 10 million That's 8 million. Okay. So, are we up to here? Yep, great. So I get a call from two banks at the same time. HSBC Bank calls me and says, Corey, ANZ Bank, what's your price in dollar yen? 10 million. The market's at 108.60.62. I get a call from Bank of China. Corey, what's your dollar yen in 8 million? 60.62. I just quote the market rate. 60.62 both sides.
那这个时候假设汇丰银行和中国银行同时给我打来电话都问我美元对日元的市场报价是怎么样，我就会给他们同样的报价，108.6，108.62。
So my HSBC will hit me on the offer. They buy at 62. Bank of ChinaWill hit me at 60, right? They want to sell it to me at 60. So therefore, there's no risk. You know, I just made, well, there is a little bit of risk. I'm still long 2 million at 108. I'm short. So at the moment, my position is that I'm square 8 million. Square. And there's two pips, 60.62, that's two pips. Right? So what's that?Right. So instantaneously, I made $1,600 US, no risk, right? Because I made two pips from that. Understand?
我给大家来解释一下。这个时候呢，汇丰银行要求买入一千万美元对日元，而中国银行希望卖出800万日元对日元。这个时候，大家注意。其中有800万的成交额，我是完全无风险的，因为一方买入，一方卖出。我会以108.62的价格卖给汇丰银行，然后以108.6的价格从中国银行买入。这时候我就有了两个点的无风险获利。那乘以800万呢？就是$1,600，这就是我通过无风险的交易模式获得的收益。那即使我还暴露在一点风险之下，就是因为他们俩的仓位规模不同，这时候我还有200万的空头仓位在108.62这个位置。
So this is all I have to manage. So that 8 million is risk-free.
那这个部分就是我们同样要关注管控风险的部分，因为其他部分已经是没有任何风险的了。
Okay, so that's how, you know, we can go for a risk-free trade.
那这就是一种重要的方式，我们进行无风险交易。
Another one more, is if I have an order, say, to buy 5 million at 108, say 10, and I have a stop loss order to sell say, for example, this is, doesn't matter, HSBC again, and this is Bank of China, that's their order.
那我将为大家介绍另外一种方式去进行无风险的套利。那我们再举同样的例子。那汇丰银行呢，希望买入$5,000,000对日元在108.1这个价格。那同时我们又有中国银行的止损单，在108.1的时候卖出$5,000,000对日元。
Now I have to tell you something that's very honest and It is what it is. You can't hide it. It's how the market works. And you may understand why, because you may experience it yourself.
那接下来我会以一种很诚恳的方式给大家介绍，讲一件事情，那大家也会自己在生活中有所感触。
So if the market went down to 108, say 6, suddenly.
那假设市场价格突然，就是无任何预兆的下跌到108.06。
Like instantaneously, you know how sometimes you can see the market drop a lot, right?
就像断崖式下跌一样，就大家经常会在K 线图上看到。
Okay, so this order is done, right?
第一个订单会立刻被执行，大家是否理解？
Right. And this order is also done.
那第二个订单也同时会被执行，因为都已经触发了相应的价格。
Does everyone understand why the orders are done?
大家都理解吗？为什么会被执行？
Right, because the market has gone through. And so here, stop loss. I can call the bank and say that's done. I have to call him and say that. I have to call him or her and say this is also done, but you're done at 108.09.
这个时候可能出现的情形呢，就是。当这两个交易完成的时候，并不是按照他们给我的指令所完成的，因为市场的下跌发生是非常突然的，并不可能在这一个价位成交到所有就是客户给到我们的规模也好，价格位也好。
So I made one pip risk free.
那我们的成交价格也有可能是108.09，那这个时候我们就有了一个点差的无风险获利。
So that's why two reasons why I want to tell you this. Two reasons why I want to tell the audience this.
我想跟大家说到这一点是有两个原因。
The first one is that's how there's slippage in the market. No one can guarantee you stop loss level, even in the international.Bank interbank level.
第一个原因呢，就是这是毫无避好好没有任何办法避免的，就是滑点的发生，这是客观存在的，是我们并没有办法改变它。
They can't guarantee you, right?
任何银行都无法确保你可以在某一个点位达到你所要求的交易。
So sometimes that's why if you're already trading now, you experience that your stop loss, your cut loss level is, you know.A little bit worse than your stop loss order.
那我相信这点大家如果做交易的话一定深有体会，你的止损单常常不是发生在你希望的位置上，通常会低一点点。
Does that happen to you before?
大家是否经历过呢？
Well, it happens in the real bank as well. You know, so anybody, and the second reason why I want to tell you is that any broker who promised you fixed spread.Guarantee stop loss is not going through the international market.
那第二点原因，我想，第二个原因，我说这个故事的是想告诉大家，如果有经纪商告诉你，我们损失是一定是确保执行start again.
No, what which part? Which part are you lost? Which part are you lost?
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
Surrender. 第二个原因我想告诉大家的原因就是如果有经纪商向你承诺他们的止损单是100%按照你的价位所执行的，那一定是骗人的。
So that's how two ways banks can have risk-free trades.
那以上就是银行进行无风险套利的两种方法。
So after telling you all these nice stories, does a traderDoes a trader for a bank have an advantage over other banks, or you?
接下来一个问题就是，银行的交易员是否比个人或者其他银行的交易员有交易上的优势？
The answer is yes, they do have an advantage over you because they are a price maker. But they really don't have an advantage over other banks except if they have a bigger customer base. The more clients you have, the more orders you have, that means you are more advantageous than other banks. For the reasons why I tell you.
这里我们的回答是相比于银行不一定，因为银行的规模不同，银行如果拥有更多的客户，那它就会拥有更多的交易优势。那对于个人来说，确实是有很多优势在里面。
So yeah, the more clients you have, the better you're in a position to make money for the banks. You know, for the reasons I told you.
那我们刚才已经提到了，更多的客户带来更多的交易量，这样的话，你可以利用更多的资源去为你的银行赚钱。
And it's also advantageous to have good relationships with people in the market as well, because, you know, they could share information, legal information, not illegal information, not inside information, but legal information, so that, you know, you don't get caught on the wrong side. I'll give you an example later. Just translate it.
Okay. 那第三个原因呢，就是说。因为银行的交易员在行业内通常都会维持很好的关系，与其他的银行也好，与其他的机构企业客户也好，那这些良好的关系呢，就会为我们带来一些消息来源。这些消息来源不是指非法的，像内幕消息等，那也许只是一些暗示，或者是合法的，以一种合法的途径获得的。接下来我会给大家一个例子。
Okay.
Example.
So what I mean by better relationship is that, you know, I could have like a friend who I deal with, Bank of China. Mm-hmm. We talk every day. You know, we say, what do you think of dollar yen? Will it go up? Will it go down? We talk like that, you know, just to get each other's view. And then we share our view, which is okay. But then, you know, Bank of China might have $500 million to buy on that day.And because I have a good relationship with him, he cannot tell me that that's illegal.
那接下来我的例子就是说，比如说我和中国银行的一个交易员每天会沟通，在开盘之前会沟通，你觉得今天的市场走势会是怎么样？这是完全OK 的，是不会触犯法律的，因为我们只是在分享观点。那比如说今天中国银行的这个交易员他接到了一个订单，要买入$500,000。那
you know, so then you know he would say, look, today I don't want to be short. I don't want to be short today.
那这个时候呢，他在因为他
跟我 I don't want to sell today. I don't want to sell.
Okay.他因为跟我有很好的关系，也许就会在跟我的聊天过程中透露出，今天我一定不想卖出美金对日元。
And I'll ask him why.
那我就会很好奇为什么呢
？And he'll say, I just don't want to sell today, okay?
他说我就是不想说，我就是不想卖。
Okay, is that okay? Okay, okay. So then, you know, that's sort of information. It's he's not telling me.Anything illegal, he's just telling me that I just don't feel comfortable getting selling today, knowing what he knows. Now, I can't ask anymore. He cannot tell me anymore. Otherwise, we are doing illegal things.
那这就是事情突然就是这样发生的。他不会告诉我他有这样一个订单的存在，只是告诉我我今天就是不想卖。那这样的信息交流是完全不会涉及到内幕消息或者是这种非法的事情的。
But here's the thing, this is not guarantee. He's not the answer.
但是我们同样要注意，他的警告并不是一定是正确的。
What if Citibank has got $2 billion to sell?
那这个时候也许远在纽约的花旗银行，它有有20亿的订单需要卖出。
Right? So, you know, even though it's good information or a hint, you know, it doesn't mean that he's right. But, you know, that's why the market is fair. In a sense that you can have a good relationship, sometimes you have good days, sometimes you have bad days. But, you know, that's something, the information you get, sometimes, most of the time, it's useful, you know, and it does help. And throughout the day, the traders will see how the market moves, and then through the time, he can decide whether is the information good, is the information bad, and he will soon realize.
那虽然我们得到了来自中国银行的暗示或者是消息也好，但是我们也可以看到他说的并不一定是正确的，因为市场很大，市场很公平，还有更多的买家卖家存在，我们并不能保证他是唯一最大的那一个空方或者是多方。那
The second part, I don't know what the second part is. It's you know, sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad information. We don't know, but during the day, we can assess it.
那这个时候呢，就说来自朋友之间的这种暗示也好，透露也好，它有可能是好消息，也可能是坏消息。我们并不能保证。我们要做的呢，就是当你获得这一信息的时候，就是要看一下盘面，看一下盘面到底是如何走的，然后做出自己的决定。
Okay, so that's how, you know, the reason why I tell you about relationship with banks is that if you deal with a broker who has people in the office who has traded before like me or have still got relationships with other banks, that would be very useful. What I'm saying is that, you know, if the audience here have got an account with a provider, and if they can find out that that provider has got like ex-traders like myself or people who have worked in the bank who still have relationships with people in the market,
yeah,
that would be quite useful.
Okay. 那这时候我想跟大家说的呢，就是说如果你选择的外汇交易平台商在之前有银行工作，或者是在银行中仍然有很好的人际关系，那对你的交易是十分有利的。
So if you have a company that just wants to sell, 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 open account, sell, sell, open account, trade, that's not so good for you.
那如果这些经纪商只是告诉你不断地向你卖东西，然后卖他们的产品平台，只是鼓励你去交易，而没有给你提供一些这样的消息的便利也好，服务的资讯也好，都是不好的。
Okay, so hopefully all this information is useful to you. Hopefully all the information I've said today is useful to you about how banks inside the banks work.
Okay.希望我今天带给大家的知识是对大家有用的。
So now I'm going to finish up soon.
那这是我们的最后一个问题。你
Can you use the strategies I told you for yourself?
大家是否可以借用交易员的策略来盈利？
The answer is yes, and I'll tell you why. We always trade with risk management in our mind.Every trade we do, we must know first how much we are risking before we make that decision.
那我们的答案是当然是可以的，但是这里有几个问题准备给大家。第一个就是，对于每一笔交易，银行的交易员都会有一套完整的风险控制策略。他知道他在做每一笔交易，之前他都知道他的风险有多大，你是否有？
So do you think about that when you put a trade? Or is it buy, sell, cheap, cheap, buy, cheap, buy?
大家是否在交易前想过这个问题？是否知道你的风险有多少？还是只是简单的买或者是卖？
Because that's what I find in my experience. A lot of retail people, they think dollar yen 120, down to 110, down to 100. You know, cheap, cheap, 110, 20, 120.Down to 110, cheap, buy. You know, but you don't know where the bottom is. And, you know, if you don't have risk management in place, it's not the way to trade.
那我在生活和我工作的经历当中就会发现，很多人都会在自己认为价格便宜的时候买入。比如说一块某个东西一块二到了一块一，这个时候他就会觉得哎呀很便宜，我要买。 但是他并不会考虑背后的风险和以及带来可能的损失。
So, I guess, you know, never say cheap or expensive in the foreign exchange market.
对，所以大家一定要记住，在外汇交易的过程当中，永远不要说贵或者是便宜。
So, as traders, we are very disciplined. Well, we have to be, because if we don't, we lose our job.
第二个就是说，作为银行的交易员，他需要严格的遵守规则，否则的话，他就会有可能失去他的工作。
So, are you disciplined when you do your trading? You are your own boss.
那对于您来说，是否也遵守了同样的规则？是否也如此的严格的遵守你为自己制定的投资规则？
And every trader, we have targets every year, and you know, we have limits every day. Do you have limits and targets for yourselves when you trade, or do you trade hoping to make money today, hoping it's a lucky day, and hoping it's, you know, that it's not a bad luck day?
那第三个呢，就是说每一个交易员他们拥有每年的盈利目标和每天的损失限额，大家是否有想过这个问题？还是说只是觉得哎，今天运气很好，我买赢钱了，或者第二天我今天运气不好，输了很多，这样比较随意的投资方法。
So where you need to think about is, you know, to use the strategies, you first of all have yourself a capital management plan.
那以上我们说到的这些呢，其实都是涉及到资本的管理计划，这个是非常重要的。
And after the capital management plan, then you need to have a trading plan from that.
当你有了资本管理计划，你同样需要一个交易计划。
So, I mean, what a anyone know what a capital management plan is? Has anyone heard of one?
大家以前是否听说过资本管理计划？有人听说过吗？
Anyone?
没有。
Very good, sir. One, two.Three. Right, not good enough. And what about trading plan? What about trading plan?
大家是否有交易计划?
A trading plan, like for example, is should I buy 100,000? Should I buy 50,000? You know, how much should I risk? Should I double up? Should I buy more? Should I sell more? Those sort of things. You've got to have all that in your head on paper first before you make a decision.
那交易计划通常是指你买入的规模有多大，然后你在什么价格选择止损，什么价格选择补仓，类似于这样的东西，你是否有写在纸上的计划？当你做投资决定的时候。
So I'm going to finish up soon, and I'll have a session where you can ask me questions, and hopefully I can answer them for you.But carrying on from how to formulate a capital management plan and a trading plan, we plan to do this to our VIP customers, including yourself. You're invited to come to our VIP seminar on Monday if you wish. Just come to our booth and register yourselves. We only have limited seats, so first in, first serve.
之后呢，我会为大家准备一个问答环节。那在这之前，我想告诉大家，就是我们会在18号，也就是下周一上午10点到12点，在四季酒店举行一个外汇交易赢家的讲座。在这个讲座上呢，大家可能会了解到更多关于资本管理计划和交易计划，我会为大家做更详细的解读。那大家一会儿可以到 B04、B06的展位预约位置，因为我们的座位是有限的。
Okay, so thank you very much for your attention, and I hope I did say something that might be useful to you.
我希望今天给大家带来的知识能够为大家所用，谢谢。
Do you have any questions for me? Thank you. Do you have any questions for me?
大家是否有问题想问呢？
作为个人交易者来说，就是他的一年的合理的回报是多少？
What is a reasonable return?
What is a reasonable return for an individual investing? Well, that depends on your risk return management. That depends on you, really, what you want.
那这个问题很大程度上取决于您自己，您到底想要多大的回报。
But,
so normally, most of the people maybe run too much risk to get very high benefit.
That's right.
Very high return. That's why they lose money.
That's right.
But sometimes if they don't run the risk,
right,
they spend, they only use a little money.
Yes.
So they cannot get very high return.
That's fair.
So this is confuse the people.
That's
why they need to find a reasonable return.
Good.
For you.
Yes, that's good. So you could also say, what is reasonable return for you? If you invest, let's talk about per year. You know, what is a reasonable return for you per year? In other words, you put in $1,000, $100,000. You want to make $200,000 in 1 year? You want to make $60,000 in 1 year? Is that reasonable for you? Only you can answer. Percentage. Well, I could probably answer that generally from a funds management point of view, right? So, you know, if you put your money in a fund, if a fund manager manages your fund, then depending on your risk reward profile, right, it's reasonable to expect the funds managers to yield probably about 20-30% per annum to be conservative in this high risk, high return market. But if you want higher risk, in other words, they may lose 50% of your capital in order to make 80%, 100% return for you. So does that answer your question, sir? Thank you. Okay. Maybe you need to translate. You need to translate the question and you need to translate the answer, I hope.
All right, okay. 稍等一下，我回去回答这个问题。就是说，我们要从一个资本管理的角度来想这个问题。你
Put it in your mouth. Coming up soft. Put it in your mouth.
Okay. Yeah.
Put it.
What do you mean? Oh, okay. Yep. I'm saying that the risk return is based on the individual.The return, you know, what he expects in return, it depends on the individual.
那其实这个是非常个人化的一个情况，你期望于多少的回报，通常是出于你自己的情况而考虑的，是非常个人化的选择。我们这边没有办法做出一个非常一般的建议或者是答案。
Is that okay? Do you have a question?
I have a technical question that if a trader in a bank, that he use leverage, because our returners, when we are trading Forex, we use a 1 to 100 leverage.
That's
if
right.
A trader in a bank, did yeah. they use that leverage
right.
at the same time?
Right. So, yes, very good. Can you ask the question in Mandarin so that the people can hear?
就是我想问一下这个银行的交易员在交易的时候有没有使用杠杆？比如说他们在卖五百万的时候呢，他们是到底是用的是五百万美元还是是五万美元
？So yes, the gentleman has asked a very good question in that you know banks don't have leverage. You know we buy $5 million, $10 million, $100 million. We just buy, we just sell. We don't have leverage. However, the profit and loss is very real, right? So you shouldn't look at leverage.As something that you can make money very quickly. You should look at it as a tool where leverage is helping you perhaps to make money X amount and lose money X amount. That's what you should be looking at. And you're only using leverage in order to achieve your real profit and real loss. we don't look at leverage, but we have to look at how much money we need to make and how much money we can afford to lose in real terms. So you can work backwards and use your leverage to determine how much money you want to make and how much money you're willing to lose. And this is part of the trading plan that will help you to use your leverage in order to achieve what bankers need to achieve. Set targets, tolerate limited loss. Does that make sense? Can you translate that?
I will try. Long answer.
Try, thank you. You've done very well. Thank you.
Okay. 这是一个非常好的问题。那这里我给大家答案是，对于银行来说，实际上是不存在杠杆的。我们用多少钱就换得多少的资产。那我回到杠杆这个问题，这是一个非常好有用的工具，因为它可以给我们带来超额的回报，但同时我们要注意他们会 给我们带来超额的损失，这也是我们要注意。这就是为什么我们需要一个交易计划，如何能
We use the trading plan to determine how much money we want to make and how much we're willing to lose.
Okay. 凭借于交易计划呢，我们就会明白我们到底需根据我们的自己的情况能够赚得多少的利润，而我们能够承受的损失又有多少。
Any more questions, please?
大家还有问题吗？
Too many.
I'm sorry, this is the last question.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. He's sorry, no, I'm not sorry.
问一下啊，当下现在的话，我们这个超高频那个交易，银行怎么针对这种交易策略，他们怎么对待的？超高频，好吧，超高频，对，我们现在那个全自动交那个交易系统，现在的话 ，MT 四啊，或者是 Java 啊，或者那个 SafeBranch， 很多那个程序员在做那种俄罗斯啊，或者日本很多超高频的交易。那么银行这方面怎么针对这种订单呢？怎么处理呢？啊
？His question is how to deal with the high frequency transactions.For banks.
High frequency. As you're asking me from a retailer for yourself, how do you deal with high
bank?
How do banks deal with high frequency trading? Well, we don't really. I mean, it's something that we are aware of and we need to be educated about, but we're not scared of it.Right, we deal with it. We deal with it. How do we deal with it? By managing our risk, by knowing that high frequency traders, it's all about pricing for us. It's all about what price we want to execute, what price we want to exit a trade, and what happens in between. The market decides. We don't care about that. We don't worry about that. We need to know about it, but we don't worry about it. You know, we deal with it, but.It can do whatever it likes, but we know what we need to do. We control our own destiny, and we don't try and control the market. They can high frequency, low frequency. If the price is right, we need to do what we need to do. We do it.
那这银行对这高频交易的态度呢？就是我们并不恐惧它，我们要应对它。那我们在意的是市场在我们的订单在什么价格成交，在什么价格离开，但是中间市场会发生什么，我们只需要去关注它，但是我们无法控制它。我们要做的是了解高频交易，然后以此制定我们的应对方法，然后制定我们的交易策略，而不去控制市场。
And also at the same time in these daysBanks also have systems to actually deal with high frequency trading as well as for our orders. We as traders do not take positions we before data announcements. We try not to. We don't have to.
Um,
we try not to have any positions before data release. Data release, yeah, when the data comes out. Before, we don't take any positions, we're square. Traders don't have any positions before the data comes out.
那我们的经验就是说，我们永远不会在数据或者是新闻出来之前进行交易。That's it.
Yeah, we don't have any positions. We are.
Sorry.
Yes.
Yeah.
我们会在这个大数据出去之前，就会把自己的仓位都平掉。
Yeah, we don't have any positions before data release, so that.You know, when the data comes out, it goes like this. You know, we don't want to get involved. But we have systems within the bank to deal with orders for our customers. You know, so the customers are taken care of, but we don't take a gamble on the market when the data release comes out, because that's when the high frequency, the computerized, the AEs, EAs, you know, they take over. They're too fast.As traders, we're not quick enough. We don't get involved. If there's too much risk, we don't want to touch it.
那在通常在大消息、大数据出来之后，市场就会出现一个剧烈波动的状态。这个时候呢，通常就是高频交易发生的最高的时段。那在这个期间内，我们并不想去参与其中，因为我们不想承担过多的风险。那这个时候，银行会有一个专门的系统来应对。这个时候客户所下的订单。
So that's a very good final question. Thank you very much. So I want to leave you with saying one last thing. Please, if you want to trade in this market, you want to make money, you got to manage your risk first.
那非常感谢大家的参与。那最后一句我想告诉大家的是，在进入交易市场之前，一定要知道你的管理风险的办法是什么，这是非常重要的。那今天就到这里，感谢大家。
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, sorry. You can come and talk to me at my booth if you like. Yep.
大家。